All right, here we go. Turn number four, green flag.
Bear Racing Vlogs. How are we doing, everybody? My name is Tom, and welcome to Eastern States Weekend 2023. It is absolutely pouring at my house right now. Apparently, the track is still dry. We still have some racing tonight. If you don't know, it's supposed to be Short Track Super Series and the Sportsman. The Super Series got pushed back till November. Sportsman is still on, so Sportsman, congratulations. This is your first feature video on the channel. I've been avoiding you guys for as long as possible, but I guess today I can't do that anymore. Okay, I need to hit the ATM, get gas. I'm kind of rushing because originally I was going to get there at 1. They pushed the schedule up, so now gates open at 11:30. I want to try to get my normal spot, top row, turn 1. So I kind of got to rush. It sounds like there's a lot of campers there already. All right, thank you guys for watching. Welcome to Orange County. Welcome back to the channel's official unofficial home track. 2023, the 62nd Eastern States Weekend kicks off today. Like I said before, it's just Sportsman. So it might be a quick show, it might be a long show, it depends what the rain did, but the second I passed over the Henry Hudson River, like all the rain just stopped and it was pretty much blue skies the whole time. So let's go grab our seats, maybe get something to eat and see what the track looks like. Oh boy. Ooh, that's a little muddy. Oh shit. Nah, it's really not that wet. Got lucky. When I first walked in, I thought that was a pro stock under there, but I think that's actually going to be Gary Ballou's ASA paved late model car, I guess. I'm going to take the cover off and take a look at it. I know I'm early, but with Sportsman only scheduled today, I don't think there's going to be a lot of people here. I will say, though, the amount of campers is staggering. Top row's filled. The entire camping section back there is filled. I'm just going to take full credit and say it's all because of me, and they've all seen me camp in my tent at racetracks. So I'm going to say I was the one that started the camping revolution again. You're welcome. Super DIRTcar Series trailer was supposed to be here regardless of whether or not the Short Track Super Series showed up today, because that would have been something funny to notice when you have your rival series selling merch at your race. About 20 minutes till time trials for Sportsman. I don't think the track's gonna be all that bad. I think if they just do a couple laps of a track pack with all these cars here, it should really get a lot of these ruts and jumps out of it, and sun's starting to peek out a lot more, so it should dry it up. I think we're gonna have a real racy track when everything is said and done. I think that's his ASA car. Again, I was born in 1998, so this whole ASA thing was already gone by the time I, you know, said my first word and all that. So I'm gonna rely on some of you guys to let me know if that's what that is and if I'm right or if I'm horribly wrong. Also, hopefully you guys can hear me over the music and I don't have to cut this, but If you guys have come to Eastern States before, drop some stories down in the comments, some memories you guys have of this race. I absolutely love reading stuff like that, and you know, just to be able to experience this race from different eyes and different stories and all that, it makes going to these races so much more interesting too. So, all right, let's get these cars on the track now, eh?
Not all of us were up till 4 in the morning at the 31st lap, so I was here ready to go.
They closed at midnight, so they tell me. They want to work on that race car themselves. You'll lock them.
So happy. They got a bunch of other guys searching for speed.
Yeah, there were some guys that were pretty.
Kick off!
Battle for the lead.
Oregon flag in hand here on the starter stand. We got a big race here. Thank you.
So we got about halfway through heat five, and this guy started opening up, not super hard, but enough that they had to bring the cars into pit road, and it's just been a constant downpour now. So I ran back to my car, gonna tune into the radio just to listen in. It also gives me a moment to charge my phone a little bit more and stay dry, because if you guys know the stance I sit on, no coverage at all. I'm wide open in the rain. So brief pause in the video, and then I guess we'll get back to it.
Good. Anybody else?
All right, everybody's so back up here. Okay. I missed the national anthem. I guess they had the high school band play, because it was down in Buzzies going through some of the old Hard Clay Observer magazines. And I actually picked up a couple, because here's one with my dad's old Pro Stock. And if you guys watch the Orange County video, you know, I told you guys that we used to run Pro Stocks here a lot. And here's actually a really good picture of it. I don't have a lot of memories of, you know, I have memories, but I don't have, like, memorabilia or, like, stuff like that of my dad's old team. Because, you know, this one, 2002, I was 4 years old at the time. So, you know, I wouldn't really collect these books or, you know, all the team shirts I have, you know, from when I was four definitely don't fit me anymore. And, then, you know, we got rid of those a while ago. But there's also one more here. I got one. Let me see if I can open it up quick. Yeah. So I was actually at this race, too. I remember this crash so vividly. I was over in turn three, and I remember waiting for the car to come around, and I suddenly just see the underside of a race car, and then, you know, our car doesn't come around. We're like, oh shit. So I remember so clearly running all the way down here to where they used to have like a bridge that crossed like a little stream in between the infield and the backstretch, and seeing their car, and I remember talking to Emerson there. Man, I can't believe I found a picture of that crash, man. Again, 2000, I was like 3 years old, dude. Golly. Man, this is so cool to look at. Just all the memories I have flooding back right now. You have the two Emersons, 1920 right there. Haikowski's running in his 45. The rare time they actually spelled his name right. There we are up there. Pat O'Mara was our driver at the time in the 621. Remember Dan Kelleher. They don't have Jimmy Pender in the 48. I remember a 313 car. It's not showing up on here, at least. I don't see Wayne Taylor in the 58 either. But man, this is cool. All right. Well, anyway, back to Eastern States racing.
Yeah.
through this one transfer spot that they did.
Guys, I don't know if it's the reason for the yellow, but we do have slight raindrops coming down.
So I'm going to turn to number 3 and 4 and put it back on the front of the racing one more time. If we're coming there, pace as the pole sitter. That championship goes once I take my first time.
just as hard, see?
It's severe too.
Well, everybody gave it their best shot, but at the end of the day, there's nothing we could have done. That was funny though, because we're all sitting up there in the bleachers. I felt one drop hit my back. I saw one hit my knee, and then it was just whoosh. I'm gonna go. I don't think they're getting the rest in tonight. There's the radio. It is 10:30 right now, so I'm gonna end it here. Thank you guys so much for watching this one. It's been up and down, but hopefully this was an entertaining video. Be sure to like the video if you guys made it this far. Follow me on Facebook. I also have a Twitter, Bear Racing Vlogs. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys next time.